All right, what's up, people? I'm gonna go. I don't like that. All right, hold on. All right, I'm going to get a shower. I'm in Denver at the TA. There's two TAs here in Denver, so I'm in one of them. I got through the Rockies. I got through the canyon, like his double K. It's like a forest canyon area out of Utah. So. Just a couple things. I tried to give y'all some Ryan videos showing me just driving and listening to music. I hope it picked it up on his phone. I haven't really played with it to see if it worked. And then I'm going to set it up to where I can actually let you guys see out the front window while I'm driving. But I have to do it in the day because this phone doesn't have good nighttime capability. My goal is to eventually get better cameras, but I got other priorities right now, guys. A little tired. I had planned on going a little further, but the Rockies and the canyon out of Utah, they kicked my butt. I mean, it's two mountainous areas, and I've got almost 40,000 pounds of frozen crap in the van. So my grade ups were like between 25 and 35 miles an hour. And again, you guys know I don't go down fast, so I hazards on up, hazards on down, and I go between 35 and 45 down, depending on where I was at and how I feel about the grades. This was very curvaceous, and I haven't seen how this is loaded. If it was all loaded on the floor, I probably took the curves a little faster, but I slowed down for quite a few of those. So it was supposed to take, once I got up this morning, it was supposed to take about 7 hours and change to get through from Salina, Utah, all the way here to the Rockies. Oh no, excuse me, to this truck stop. It took me almost 10 with the grades of climbing because it's really posting, it's doing my speed limit at about 55 miles an hour when it does the estimate on the GPS. I can tell I'm sorry because I'm talking slow. Do that, and then Bill had called me. Well, I tried to call him. He called me tonight. We were doing phone tag, and he said, when you come out of the mountain, he said, make sure you are careful because he used to live here. His wife had property, you know, his wife had inherited a family home, and they lived here for a while. He said, when you hit St. George, there's been two trucks that were blown over. So I wanted to share this with my newbies and whoever I wanted to hear who. Our drivers who have to deal with snow, inclement weather, and wind. So when you guys start doing this, because a lot of us, when we come here in Chuckin, we're coming from wherever we're from. And it's like, I didn't know, coming from Arizona, I didn't know there was such thing as ice fog. And so here I am riding like the wind. Back in the day, I'm hauling 65 hard. I got a nice straightaway. It was nighttime. Had the music cranked. This was with Conway. And all of a sudden, I could see what looked like little moisture crystals, but they weren't really doing anything. I put my hand down. The air was moist. I just didn't think it didn't wet my hand like a rain. What I found out is that that's known as ice fog, and it's leaving little crystals of ice all on the ground. And if the temperature is right, they're not melting. They're turning into black freaking ice. Which is why people weren't on the road. It was me, and I think I saw only one other car. All the truckers had gotten off probably because they had checked. So what I learned, this is in the early days of driving. When you're driving areas that you know have some certain weather conditions. So if you know, I'm ashy again now, tired. You're driving, let's say, I want to use an example, Oklahoma. Let's use a non-snow area. What we know about Oklahoma, what's his big weather issue? Tornadoes. So, since we know that, we know when those seasons are around, then we need to check the weather to see what's going on. If you're in Colorado, like I am right now, you're checking for snow. Now, to be honest, I've never checked for wind in Colorado. I don't know why I never just did it because my always been focus has always been snow. Oh, this is my, I got this at one of the truck stops on sale. The donations go to breast cancer. And I like, you know what, it's weird. I like pinks. I mean, I'm kind of a big tomboy, but I love certain pinks. And this is kind of cool. I like the knit on it, everything. It's kind of cool. And it's actually warm. It's very well knitted. So it's actually very warm. I even got the little breast cancer pin. It was like a couple bucks. But everything you buy goes to breast cancer, so. We tend to only verify what we think, and we should really listen to all of it. So I didn't know about the high winds. Bill told me, and then I went on to on in our trucks we have weather van on the radio. So I went to weather van, and they said 35 mile an hour gusts. Now, real quick for my newbies, I should have video on here. I think where I talked about this a little bit. I have my own philosophy when it comes to wind and wind gusts. As to what I will drive, when I will shut it down. If I'm empty in the box and they tell me 35 mile an hour winds, the truck gets cut down. It gets stopped. If it tells me anything over 10, over probably about 10 to 15 mile an hour winds, the truck is gonna be parked. And the reason it's parked is because I don't have enough weight to hold me down. And not flip the damn truck over. If I'm heavy in the box, I'm like where I'm at right now, 35 mile an hour gust, not nothing. Now, when you start getting up to your 50 mile plus gust, again, you've gotta, anything over 50 miles, you need to be parked. The 50 mile an hour, you gotta see how it's blowing, but you may make the decision to park there too. So normally I have driven up to 55, 50 miles an hour with gust. Gust, GUST. Anything over that, I don't mess with. Loaded or empty. Because this is a big old target. Push you right over. So coming out of doing the whole Rockies thing, I was just sitting there driving. And while I was coming through, I started thinking about Grind Mo-J. And I just thought about him and the fact that you're so excited. You remind me a little bit of me. And you, because I was so excited and nervous and all of those things at the same time. And so what you reminded me of was this. I remember I had come and I had my first trip into the Rockies. I was scared to death. And all the truckers were telling you, oh, you go through the Rockies, you gonna see broken up trucks from where they crashed in the Rockies. I'm gonna tell you, older truckers like to screw with you, okay? You are not gonna see a broke up truck in the Rockies unless that crap just happened. So if it gets a rollover, they're getting it cleaned up pretty quickly. And I kind of laughed to myself and my buddy Anthony, when I said peed in the cup and talked to me out of trucking in my early years. He came into trucking for a little bit a while back. It's a long time ago, and I didn't know this until after he had gotten in and left. But he turned around and Anthony had. He said when he went through the Rockies, nervous as hell. He told me, he said, I prayed over the truck. I walked around and I headed out that morning. He said, and then Shannon, I went ahead and parked in the Rockies and slept there overnight. So when I had it, I was talking to him. When I was back, when I was with the same company I'm with now, and Anthony said to me, because I told him, I said, I'm so nervous. He said, girl, go in today. Don't go at night. Because I was going to be going in at night. He said, go at night. He said, go during the day. You need to see it. So for all of you guys that can, if you haven't driven the Rockies, if you ever get an opportunity, try to make sure you get yourself scheduled to go during the day. The Rockies is breathtaking. It's gorgeous. It's beautiful. You're driving against streams. You're gonna see a lot of wildlife. One of my favorites to see is a live mountain goat with the curled horns. So I saw mountain goats and just some really neat, the forest area, the mountains, the resorts and skiing lodges. Gorgeous. Still dealing with it, y'all. Still dealing with it. Not as bad, but still dealing with it. I'm gonna give you something to drink. But you're seeing all that. It's gorgeous. So the Rockies is a very only word I can use is breathtaking. It is actually probably one of the more breathtaking places I have driven through, next to the Grand Canyon and the coast of Oregon. It is very pretty. But you're not going to see broke up trucks unless it just happened and get that cleaned up very quickly. Take your time when you go through there. Not going too slow. I mean, you can't go, if you're going, you shouldn't be going below 25 miles an hour. But I normally, when I went through there, I go 35, 45, and people don't like it, didn't go around, you know. So if you get under 40 miles an hour, you need to put your hazards on and then just go on through. But it's gorgeous. Very, very pretty. So, yeah, I'm a little tired right now, so I don't know if I'm doing this tonight. I might do, because I have some more stuff I want to talk about. But yeah, I'm gonna be. So I'm going to sleep in a minute after I get my shower. I just really need a shower. I was gonna try to wash, but I don't feel like washing nothing. So I'm gonna get my shower and come back here to the truck and pass the hell out. And then get up in the morning and I might do some cleaning in the truck, because my truck is a mess right now. Anyway. To the rhythm like a rhyme, I'm a tongue-tied chilling with the DKKA, Richard B-I-C-L-D, and B-E-N-T-H-O-U-S-C. Continue on to I-17. I snap my fingers twice like a bunch of bitches proud of me because he's overwhelmed. You know I get you around when I kick it, my name is Quicken, Master Digger, then I'm who's kicking when she trick it. My voice is the trigger, go deep like an ABC, got a squirming like a eel. The kiss on the cheek is rather big, I'd rather run.